roller coasters, one of mankind's greatest innovations in the amusement industry.
Today, there are more than 1,400 roller coasters worldwide, with more than 270 million people visiting amusement parks every year.
But how exactly did these magnificent creations come to be? To find out, we must look back centuries in order to explore the origins of the roller coaster.
In this journey, we are taken back to the palace gardens of 17th century with the construction of ice slides. These elementary fabrications integrated sled riding on extensive and steep wooden slides coated with ice. Given a favorable temperature and angle, a new type of amusement ride was created. These were known as the Russian Mountains, exceeding the first threshold and providing a temporary gravity-powered thrill for the upperclassmen. Such rides were used for historical figures, including Catherine II of Russia.
Eventually, during the early 19th century, the extent of Russian influence spread beyond boundaries, reaching the domain of France. As a result, in July of 1817, French banker Nicolas Bujon opened the Parc Bujon, an amusement park located in Paris. The most magnificent attraction, you ask? The roller coaster, known as the Promenades Aériennes or Aerial Strolls, featuring locked wheels and guide rails with the conditions of optimal speeds and curving tracks. A roller coaster with a permanent build and complete circuit was created, surpassing a second threshold of complexity. In addition, such roller coasters began to diversify and were marketed towards the general public.
The influence of roller coasters eventually spread to the United States with the construction of downhill railroads by railway companies. These railroads eventually developed into complete circuits with the purpose of providing entertainment. However, by 1885, Philip Hinkle introduced a popular attraction known as the Gravity Pleasure Road. But something about this roller coaster separated it from many others. It was the first roller coaster with a lift hill, with hooked chains and an anti-rollback device, along with the optimal angle of elevation. The cart could now be mechanically lifted toward a peak, where it could then descend with higher gravity-powered speeds. Roller coasters now pass the third threshold.
Roller coaster designs became more experimental, mechanized, and complex during the 1880s. As a result, they became more dangerous than ever before. Take the Flip-Flap Railway by engineer Lena Beecher, for example. The first roller coaster to use a vertical loop. In it, riders experienced 12 G's of force, consequently received dangerous whiplash. To put that into perspective, people lose consciousness at 4 G's, and fighter pilot experiences 9 G's of force. These dangerous effects were the Goldilocks conditions for the fourth threshold, upstop wheels. It was invented by John A. Miller and kept the roller coaster cart stuck to the tracks using underfriction. This was critical for the new complexity in all roller coaster rides, maintaining the safety of riders while traveling at high speeds.
With the immense presence and popularity of roller coasters, a major breakthrough occurred. Disneyland, one of the most popular theme parks in the world, released the first roller coaster to utilize tubular steel track. This ride was known as the Matterhorn Bobsleds, incorporating polyurethane-coated wheels and manipulating the physical properties of steel. The malleable and ductile nature of this material served as a catalyst for an explosion of diversification in roller coaster design. Furthermore, this innovation propagated the creation of intricate and vivid designs accommodated by faster and smoother experiences. Some roller coaster even exceeded heights of over 400 feet. It was the golden age of the roller coaster, bypassing the fifth threshold.
Over the course of history, roller coasters have been innovated. The first and traditional roller coasters were produced with wooden parts. After steel parts were used, the production of steel roller coasters rapidly surpassed the traditional ones. Although many companies and amusement parks have a few wooden coasters, other innovations of roller coasters include floorless rides. The first few roller coasters were in a mining theme, where the body of the rider was enclosed in the ride. Now there are numerous rides that have the legs of the riders dangling from the ride.
Many roller coasters today illustrate the numerous innovations mentioned previously. For example, a traditional wooden roller coaster that is still in an amusement park would be Ghost Rider, located in Knott's Berry Farm. Numerous floorless rides exist today, but a famous one also located in Knott's Berry Farm is called Silver Bullet. A roller coaster was made and placed at Cedar Point in Ohio, breaking a 200-foot boundary. This coaster was called Magnum XL 200.
The next big innovation for roller coasters is the expansion of virtual reality enhanced roller coasters. While there are many traditional roller coasters, such as the Jaguar from Knott's Berry Farm, a two-person ride, these virtual reality enhanced roller coasters would only be available to single riders. Virtual reality headsets would only sync to the movement of the ride and form images that would give a new experience to all riders.
In conclusion, we'd like to emphasize the evolution of roller coasters over time, how it became something from nothing, from its humble beginnings in Russia and France, to the creations of today's generation. Roller coasters have experienced a revolution in design, concept, and architecture. So the next time you visit Knott's Berry Farm or Disneyland, appreciate their creativity and inspiration. And most of all, don't forget to have fun.